Good morning, everyone. In September, the chairman announced the release of a majority staff report on the data breaches at the Office of Personnel Management. This committee spent a year digging into what went wrong at OPM. We looked at everything from how the hackers got into what technologies OPM was buying while responding to the incident. And while we learned a great deal, there was an unfortunate conclusion that the damage of this data breach could have been mitigated. It's impossible to prevent all data breaches, especially when we are talking about a determined and sophisticated adversary, but we can deter and mitigate the effects of these breaches. Some of that, like investigation, attribution, and prosecution, is outside the agency's control, but other aspects, like improving cybersecurity protections and continuous monitoring, are squarely within agency CIO's control. That is why we need to get into the weeds on everything from access controls to vulnerability management to make sure we aren't making it easy for hackers to get access to our sensitive data. And this is a conversation that starts with the agency CIO. CIOs are the focal point for all things information technology at every federal agency, department, office, and bureau. That is why this subcommittee has worked together to ensure the continued implementation of FITARA, and more broadly, making sure that CIOs have the necessary authorities to finally bring federal systems into the 21st century. The House recently passed my bill, the MGT Act, co-sponsored by Mr. Connolly, Chairman Chaffetz, Ranking Member Cummings, Ranking Member and my friend, Ms. Kelly, the Majority Leader, the Minority Whip, and Mr. Liu from California, which incentivizes agency CIOs to modernize their agency's outdated legacy IT through fiscal responsibility. I urge the Senate to pass the MGT Act as Congress so that incoming administration has the necessary tools to modernize our outdated and insecure federal IT. This is a shared responsibility. Congress can't hold agency CIOs accountable for what's going on in IT if those CIOs don't have the necessary authorities to get the job done. We need CIOs staying at their post for longer than the current two-year average. If we're going to move the ball forward, we need federal CIOs not only with the necessary authorities to make their vision a reality, but who are sticking around long enough to see it happen. This is why the OPM CIO was such a focus of the OPM data breach report and its recommendations. We need empowered, accountable, and competent CIOs, which brings us to our panel here today. We need a serious conversation about the role of the federal CIOs in information security. The President recently announced the creation of a federal CISO, the Chief Information Security Officer, that will report to the federal CIO. Should that be a model for federal agencies, the CISO reporting to the CIO? Or should the CISO report directly to the head of the agency? Does the head of an agency need to hear two voices on questions of IT procurement, computer systems, data storage, and balancing the needs of the production environment with those of cybersecurity? This is an open question that this subcommittee has not yet explored, but I think it is an important question moving forward as we continue to conduct oversight of federal information security policies and practices. And finally, we need to address how these agencies transition their information technology over to the new administration. Each agency will have unique challenges, and I would like to hear from our witnesses how they are going to facilitate this transition. We are making progress in information technology and cybersecurity, and I'm committed to ensuring that we don't backslide on this profound national security challenge. Ultimately, cybersecurity is a collaborative effort that is going to require continuous attention and effort from all parties to make sure our data is safe. And I'm glad